गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग। Write one question. Fe2O3 plus 3H2 Fe2O3 plus 3H2, this is solid, this is gas, gives 2 Fe solid plus 3H2O. 2 Fe solid plus 3 H2O. Fe2O3 plus 3 H2 gives 2 Fe plus 3 H2O. Calculate delta RH. Calculate delta RH. Calculate delta RH. So here, what is delta RH? Delta RH is equal to Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Delta RH is equal to enthalpy of the products minus enthalpy of the reactants. Enthalpy of the products, that means this sigma delta HM of, that is twice HM of Fe plus thrice HM of H2O. Minus HM of Fe2O3 plus thrice HM of H2. So enthalpy of the products minus enthalpy of the reactants. So what is enthalpy of Fe? Element it is to be taken as zero. Element it is to be taken as zero. This value is given in the numerical. Write the value. That is delta FH standard. Formation value. Delta FH standard is equal to of Fe. Of Fe is equal to zero, that is elemental state. Then delta FH standard of H2O, this value already we know, that is 285.8 minus 285.8 kilojoules per mole. And delta FH standard of Fe ho gaya, H2O ho gaya, then this will be zero. That is delta FH standard of H2, that is zero. Then delta FH standard of Fe2O3 of Fe2O3, which is equal to, that is given, the value is given, minus 824.2 kilojoules per mole. All right. So you find out that Hamilton is less than. So what you have to do to get delta R H standard of this reaction? So all standard values are given. Delta R H standard. Delta R H standard is equal to that is products minus reactants of this reaction. Standard enthalpy of this reaction is equal to delta R H standard is equal to you see what are the products? Products coming back to that equation. Products minus reactants, that is 2 into 0 Fe, 2 into 0 plus 3 into minus 285.8 minus of, so products minus reactants. What are the reactants? Fe2O3 and H2. So for that, minus 824.2 plus zero of that of H2. So this is of H2, this is of Fe2O3, and this is of water, thrice water. This is of 2 Fe, this is of Fe2 Fe. So when you calculate, I'm giving you the answer, that is minus 33.3 kilojoules per mole. So delta R H standard enthalpy of a reaction. Standard enthalpy of a reaction is equal to standard enthalpy of products minus standard enthalpy of reactants. So in this case, see, elemental standard enthalpy of formation of elements is taken as zero. And what is given in the balanced chemical equation, those numbers, they are in moles, not molecules in thermodynamics. Not one sentence. Write one sentence. Delta F H standard of an element is taken as zero. Delta F H standard of element is taken as zero. Number two, in thermochemical equation, coefficient refers to number of moles. Coefficient refers to the number of moles, not molecules. Now here in this, we have seen this delta R H standard. Delta R H standard is equal to minus 33.3. if I balance this equation in a different way, that is half Fe2O3, it was 3H2, so I'm taking half. 3/2 H2 gives, next it was Fe, that is 2 Fe, so 2 Fe, I'm taking 1 Fe, that also I divided by 2. Then what else? 3H2O was there and I divided that also by 2. Means the whole thing I divided by 2. And when you calculate delta R H of this reaction, you will be getting, that is minus 16.6, which is half of this when I balanced that chemical equation in a different way, in what way? I took half. That is Fe2O3. It was Fe2O3. I took half. H3H2, I took half. 2Fe, I took half. 3H2O, I took half. Means I multiplied all by half. So I had to multiply this also by half. That means enthalpy is an extensive property. When you add these things, you can add. When you divide, when you take the half, then you have to take the half of this value. That means according to the balancing, this value calculated is also changed. Addition, see, half, then I took that half. When you calculate, you will be getting -16.6. That means enthalpy is an extensive property. One more sentence you write. When a chemical reaction is reversed, then the sign of delta R X standard is also reversed. Suppose I write this ulta, that one this side and this one that side. Then instead of -16.6, I have to take that opposite sign, that is +16.6. If you change products and reactants, means if you reverse an equation, then this value should also be reversed. So enthalpy is an extensive property. Enthalpy of an extensive property. And when you reverse the chemical equation, that delta R H standard is also reversed. Next heading, Hess's law of constant heat summation. Next heading, Hess's law of constant heat summation. Hess's law of constant heat summation. Right on. It states that enthalpy change of a reaction is the same. Enthalpy change of the reaction is the same. Whether it occurs in single steps or in several steps. Whether it occurs in single step or several steps. Same reaction, if it undergoes through a series of steps. So you add all the enthalpy changes in all the steps. You keep on adding, then you will be getting the final equation step. When the same reaction is going through different steps, to get that enthalpy change for the first reaction, what you have to do? You have to add all the intermediate reactions. Suppose one reaction is taking place through two steps. So two equations are there. Enthalpy change for these two equations you add, you will be getting this total enthalpy change, that is for the first equation. Let's see that. You know that carbon combines with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. This reaction, carbon solid, oxygen gas, and carbon dioxide gas, and this enthalpy change for this reaction, that is delta R H standard is equal to -393.5 kilojoules per mole. So this is one reaction. I'm going to divide this reaction into two steps, two intermediate steps. First is what carbon combines with. So this is the reaction. This is the entire reaction. I'm going to break this reaction into different steps. Same reaction. That is carbon solid means graphite plus half O2 gas gives first carbon monoxide gas is formed. In that case, delta R H is equal to delta R H is equal to minus 110.5 kilojoules per mole. Delta R H standard is equal to minus 110.5 kilojoules per mole. Now carbon monoxide is reacting with oxygen again to form carbon dioxide. So final product is attaining in the second step. So carbon monoxide gas plus half O2 gas gives, don't think that this is half molecule, this is half mole. In thermochemical equation, this coefficients are not molecules, they are moles. So this is CO2 gas. Now the final product is being reached. Now if delta R H standard is equal to minus 283 kilojoules per mole. Now you see, I divided the first equation into A and B. This first equation, I divided that equation into two half equations, A, equation A, equation B. Now when you add these two things, you will be getting minus 393.5. The same reaction I am taking through different steps. So enthalpy change of this reaction is the sum of the enthalpy changes of the steps to which that first reaction is divided. So I am going to add this thing. I am going to add these two, that is carbon solid plus half O2 gas. Left to left. Adding means left to left and then right to right. So Cu gas plus half O2 gas gives Cu gas plus CO2 gas. Now what you have to do, common things you cancel. You cannot see. I'll be writing on the top again. That is C solid plus half O2 gas plus CO gas plus half O2 gas gives CO gas plus CO2 gas. I added these two equations, so I have to add those two things also. Now here, half O2, that is 1O2. See, 1O2. CO gas and CO gas, these things are common, so that got cancelled. So final equation comes to what? C solid plus half O2, that is this O2. Gives that CO2, and when you added these two things, you are getting that minus, that is 11 plus 285, that is minus 285 283, then you will be getting it as minus 393.5 kilojoules per mole. So same reaction, if you are dividing into several steps, this enthalpy is also got dividing into several steps. Enthalpy is an extensive property. So here you add these different steps, you will be getting the final one. Or for making that final one, you find out such reactions. For example, calculate delta F H standard. Calculate delta F H standard of CH3OH liquid. CH3OH liquid from the following data. This is formation. Delta FH standard means formation equation. What is formation equation? Formation equation, for formation equation, CH3OH liquid, that is the most stable state. It should be made from its elements. That means C solid, yes, C graphite plus 4OH, that means 2H2 gas plus then 1O, that means you have to take elemental state, so half O2. This is the formation equation. I have written this because here it is F is asked, formation value is asked. I'm giving you different equations. It is given in the question. I'm giving you different equations. These equations you have to adjust. You have to multiply sometimes. You have to divide sometimes. Then you have to reverse the reaction. Finally, you should be able to get that equation. So accordingly, when you reverse this equation, you can reverse the sign. When you multiply by 2, then you have to multiply that value. If you are multiplying one equation by 2, then you have to multiply. What all changes you are doing on the equation, that you have to do on that value also. So formation equation is this thing, and it is given that. It is given. Some data are given. That is C graphite plus O2 gas gives CO2 gas. Value is given. That is delta H standard is equal to minus 393 kilojoules per mole. This is one equation given. Second equation given is CH3OH liquid plus 3/2 delta H value is given, that is -726 kilojoules per mole. H2 gas plus a half O2 gas is H2O liquid. Delta H standard is equal to -286 kilojoules per mole. So three equations are given. Three equations are given. Using these equations, finally you have to reach that. C graphite on the left hand side. So C graphite, this is again on the left hand side. We keep that like that only. Then 2H2, where is H2? Yes, here is H2. So I need 2H2, that on the left hand side only. So I'm going to multiply 2 into 2. This is minus 286. So into 2 means I'll be getting what here? Minus 572 kilojoules per mole. So I changed this equation. That is 2H2. 2/2 means 1. 2/2 means 1, then 2H2O. I multiplied the entire equation, so I multiplied that also. Now, oxygen you leave it. Oxygen will come on its own. Now, CH3OH, that is on the right-hand side, but here CH3OH is the left-hand side. See, left-hand side. So, I'm going to reverse this equation. So, I have to reverse that value also. This equation I have to reverse, because that is in the right hand side, but CH3OH is on the left hand side. So I am going to reverse it. So first I'll reverse, that is CH3OH liquid plus, then what? 3/2 O2. 3/2 O2. So I'll reverse here, CO2 gas plus 2H2O liquid. 2H2O liquid. I reversed this equation. So I will be reversing this value also. Minus will change to plus. See? Minus will change to plus. Now again you check carbon graphite left hand side. Left hand side. 2H2 left hand side. 2H2 left hand side. CH3OH right hand side. CH3OH right hand side. Then you will see you add now. Leaving oxygen, we are trying to add. On adding C graphite, you add and okay, on adding what you are getting, C graphite plus O2 gas plus CO2 gas plus 2H2O liquid plus 2H2 gas plus O2 gas gives what all things? CO2 plus CH3OH liquid plus 3/2 O2 plus 2H2O. So what all things? 2H2O will get cancelled. Then CO2 will get cancelled. Then, so what is remaining? Now O2, 2O2. This is O2 plus O2, 2O2. Here it is 3/2 O2. So 3/2 means 1.5. So here it will be half O2. So I'm keeping one half O2 and I remove this. So all right, now we have reached that equation. C graphite plus 2H2, that is 2H2, then half O2 here, half O2, then what this you can cancel because this is 1.5 we adjusted there, then you are getting only CH3OH. This is way you have to adjust these equations to get this final equation. Thank you.